What's going on, YouTube? Listen, I don't want to waste any time. I'm well aware it's like Christmas morning right now. J. Cole is on a brand new feature. This right here is with Lil Durk. It's none other than All My Life. One. Chalk on the sidewalk. Interesting.
Durkio told me he been on some positive shit, yeah, yeah. Lately I just wanna show up and body some shit, yeah, yeah. Always been a little mathematician. Lately this cash I'm getting got me losing count of these bags. I've been moving too fast. Hard times don't last.
Always been a mathematician, but even me, who's really good at keeping count, I'm losing count of all the success and all the M's that I'm stacking right now. J. Cole giving you those educated flex bars. Also, I love how if you listen underneath of this piano that drops in, there's like this little percussive snare roll that kind of gets introduced. And I wonder if that's like being teased, if we get a drop in of that, if the percussion does kick in. But it's like, it's just there, slightly underneath of it all.
Yeah, got me losing count of these bags. I've been moving too fast. Hard times don't last. Remember when cops are rats talking out my ass. Boy, you ain't shit but a bitch with a badge.
12 not gonna like that one, man. Shots fired at the J.
Talking out my ass. Boy, you ain't shit but a bitch with a badge.
All my life, they be trying to keep me down.
Wow.
All this time.
You know what though? Cole said it at the beginning, and we started off with that just smooth piano, and then him giving you that more melodic delivery. But you know, Durk called, and he's on his positive shit, and definitely giving you a positive vibe. He's got all the kids. They look like they're having a blast in this video. He's even got them in the mix. And I love this, how they're like singing the main harmonies. And then he's kind of out in front. Like instead of him singing the main harmony and like the kids are the backing singers, they're kind of at the forefront. And he's more so backing them up and complimenting their lines and what they say. That's dope.
All this time. Never thought I'd make it out.
Same.
No, they couldn't take me. No. All my life. They be trying to keep me down.
Is that paying homage to Forest Hills Drive right there? J. Cole on the rooftop? Looks like it.
All my life. They be trying to keep me down. I decided I had to finish, but the media called me a menace. Mm. I just sat with the mayor and politicians. I'm trying to change the image. Mm. You can't blame my past no more. I come from the trenches. Some said I'd never be a superstar, but I know I'm different. I'm the voice, but the system ain't give me a choice.
I like that line. I'm the voice, but the system never gave me a choice. I merely channeled my environment through my music, which led to my success. And y'all still want to judge me for my past and judge me for where I'm came from. Even though I'm sat here trying to create a more positive outlook and I'm trying to change the narrative, I'm still being held down. And that shirt says almost healed as well. Is he recovering from something? I don't know Lil Durk's full story. So if you want to comment below, let me know, please.
Style, but I know I'm different. I'm the voice, but the system ain't give me a choice. There's some people that still undeployed.
Or it could be a greater metaphorical, symbolic thing, like almost healed from his environment, from all the shit that he's been through. Like he's trying to heal his image. He's trying to find a way forward and find something positive now through his music. Could be.
I know I'm different. I'm the voice, but the system ain't give me a choice. Know some people that still undeployed. I know a felon who trying to get FOID. Child support, you only support.
Felon trying to get FOID? Yeah, if you're a felon trying to get a firearms license, good luck with that shit.
Know some people that still undeployed. I know a felon who trying to get FOID.
I'm pausing again. We pause a lot on this channel. Like, if you don't know that, I don't know what you're doing here. It's a breakdown channel. Anyways, the other thought that I had is maybe he was shot too and he's healing from that. I don't know. I want to know what the almost healed means, because there's definitely a deeper message and meaning with that. And it's written in like the blood red as well, which is significant.
Child support, your only support. For a visit, I'm going through courts. Went to jail, they was chaining me up. And you know that I'm famous as fuck. See how you...
Went to jail, they was chaining me up. You know I'm famous as fuck. I love how we go like high in the cadence. And then the auto tunes really like push, and then we come back down and like lower it out. So it goes high, down, very cool sort of mirror playing of two like extreme cadences positioned against each other. And then that line, child support, your only support, like the only support and assistance that you can get is through child support. You can't even get like direct support. And anyway, that's, I love that line and the way that hits. But I also feel like he's dealing with child support, because you could flip it in the other way. Like, he got no support, and yet ironically, the only support that he's getting is child support, which means it's not support because he's got to pay it. He's got to give something out, and the only way he can see his kids is through the courts.
That's still undeployed. I know a felon who's trying to get void. Child support's your only support. For a visit, I'm going through courts.
Yeah, that hits differently.
With the jail, they were chaining me up. And you know that I'm famous as fuck. See, how you gonna joke about stimulus? But they really had came in the clutch. I know some kids wanna hurt.
Shit, I'm still waiting for my COVID stimulus check.
About stimulus, but they really had came in the clutch. I know some kids wanna hurt themselves. Stop trying to take drugs.
Did he have like a sexual bar there? Came in the clutch, stimulus, stimulating, but also obviously playing off of coming in the clutch versus getting a stimulus check, getting help, and being there in the clutch.
I know some kids wanna hurt themselves. Stop trying to take drugs. I refer to myself, trying to better myself, trying to better my health, but.
Oh, J. Cole really not playing. Dirk is on some positive vibes. We're not like promoting that lean and that fentanyl on this. We're actually saying, look at me. I'm trying to heal from this. I'm trying to set an example and be a role model. Wow.
They be trying to keep me down.
All this time.
Never thought I'd make it out. No, no. No.
All my life.
Keep me down.
First generation ghetto nigga. Cold world, hello niggas. Made it out of the city with my head on straight. Niggas keep shooting up the let out. Young Jordan Peele gotta get out. Cause the shit that I spit out is a cheat.
Young Jordan Peele gotta get out. Makes me think of Key and Peele, but Jordan Peele wasn't one of his first movies as a director was Get Out. Yeah, so he's gotta get out. Like, he's trying to make it out the ghetto. He's setting the first precedent of this, of getting out of this situation and out of this violence, but then also dropping in a smooth Peele Get Out bar and double.
Generation ghetto nigga, cold world, hello niggas. Made it out of the city with my head on straight. Niggas keep shooting up the let out. Young Jordan Peele gotta get out. Cause the shit that I spit out is a cheat code, like I'm facing a Rico. A high nigga put a hit out. And another one, and another one. I got like 100 of them by the lap, nigga.
Wow, and another one, and another one. So putting out hits, like a hit to take out someone versus facing a RICO case because of that. And we all know like the Gunna and Young Thug and how like they've taken the RICO, which worked really well for the New York mobs and the Italian mafia. Now they're applying that through rap music as well, can get you incriminated on RICO charges, which is absolutely crazy. But yeah, I love the RICO bar playing off of that, but versus the hits that he's putting out in terms of music-wise. He's putting out hit after hit after hit after hit. Always so smooth with the wordplay. Mr. Cole, man.
Put a hit out, and another one, and another one. I got like 100 of them by the lap, niggas, so they think they're ahead of me, but I'm really in front of them now. Some of them fumbling, they bad, fucking up the little crumbs that they had. A reminder to humble yourself, this shit could be gone in an instant.
Man, he is just so smooth with his flows on the beats. And let's talk about the rhyme schemes a little bit here.
Niggas, so they think they're ahead of me, but I'm really in front of them now. Some of them fumbling, they bad, fucking up the little crumbs that they had.
Some of them fumbling, they bag. Some of them. See how he says some of them like that? Some of them fumbling. So then fumbling, crumbs that they had, crumbs that they. So that fits into his sort of condensed sounding rhyme scheme. And then the ag is the B rhyme. So he's got an internal rhyme, the A rhymes to the B rhyme. So he goes like,
but I'm really in front of them now. Some of them fumbling, they.
Some of them fumbling. So that's the A rhymes. They bags or what they had. So that's the B rhymes, the N rhymes.
So crumbs that they had.
And then crumbs that they had. So see how it goes A to B, A, B. Very smooth rhyme writing.
Really in front of them now. Some of them fumbling, they bad. Fucking up the little crumbs that they had. A reminder to humble yourself. This shit could be gone in an instant. Me, I'm running long distance. All pistons firing. I've been stuck between maybe retiring and feeling like I'm just not hitting my prime. These days, seeing rappers be dying.
Wow, I mean, what a dilemma, man. He's thinking about his own retirement. And then he's still questioning, has he even hit the peak yet of his lyrical capabilities? To me, Cole, I hope you never retire, man. I want more and more music and more features to break down.
Before they even getting they shine, I never even heard a little buddy. To somebody murder little buddy. Now I'm on the phone searching little buddy name. Got a plane that's tunes all day in my room. Thinking, damn, this shit wicked to get their names buzzing. Some niggas just gotta go lay in a tomb.
And wow.
Thirsty for click.
To get their names buzzing, they have to go lay in a tomb. I mean, that's crazy though, isn't it? Because it's like, we lose too much talent too soon, especially in hip hop nowadays. And it's just, it's almost criminal when you think about the fact that half of these artists get more shine when they're dead and buried than when they're here. Appreciate the ones who were here, man.
This shit wicked to get their names buzzing. Some niggas just gotta go lay in a tomb. And media thirsty for clicks. I got a new rule. If you ain't ever posted a rapper when he was alive, you can't post about him after he get hit. It's simple. It's the principle.
I like that. I like that line right there. If you're not talking about this artist when he's here, then don't sit here and jump on the bandwagon if everybody's sharing him and paying homage to him when he's gone. You can still listen to him, still support him, shit, absolutely. But don't sit there and like wave the flag on social media, because we all fall victim to that. Hell, I've probably done that too.
Gotta go lay in a tomb, and media thirsty for clicks. I got a new rule, if you ain't ever posted a rapper when he was alive, you can't post about him after he get hit. It's simple, it's the principle, on any tempo, I'm invincible. Don't even rap, I just fit to you, I'd rather that than an interview. Most days, fuck them all like I'm going through a whole...
I like that line too, man. Instead of doing interviews and going through all this, I just talk about it in my music. That's when I really am my true self and I let it all off of my chest. Man, I love, like, he gives you like wordplay. He gives you the rhyme schemes we talked about. He gives you just these buttery smooth flows. And then on top of that, it's just real shit that Cole drops you.
You can't post about him after he get hit. It's simple. It's the principle. On any tempo, I'm invincible. Don't even rap, I just vent to you. I'd rather that than an interview. Most days, fuck them all like I'm going through a whole phase. Young nigga shoot out the whip like road rage. I pray all of my dogs stay so...
Fuck them all like I'm going through a whole phase, like a whole getting around, sleeping around, but also like, I don't care, man. Fuck them all. And then shoot out the whip like road rage. So you're getting mad and like you will shoot out the whip when you're driving the car, but also like a drive-by shooting out the whip.
On any tempo, I'm invincible.
And you know what? Even like the fuck them all hoe phase and like shooting out the whip could be like a sexual innuendo. We'll give Cole a triple there.
Don't even rap, I just fit to you. I'd rather that than an interview. Most days, fuck them all like I'm going through a whole phase. Young nigga shoot out the whip like road rage. I pray all of my dogs stay so paid. And the only thing to kill him is old age. All my life.
Yeah, me too, man.
Trying to keep me down
all this time.
All this time.
Thought I would make it out.
Never thought I'd make it out.
They couldn't
break me.
No, no.
They couldn't take me. They couldn't take me.
No.
All my life.
All my life.
All
this time.
They be trying to keep me down.
Wow. That's a hell of a moment, man. You know, the thing I love about Cole is that he's never above other artists, like up and coming MCs. He always keeps like an ear to the streets in terms of who's next up. And he's always willing to like be there to support and be a role model. And I love the way that he gives back and nurtures this sense of community within hip hop. And then I got to give a huge shout out to Lil Durk, because honestly, I don't listen to a lot of Lil Durk. But after this song, I'm interested. I want to check out more, because when you can take your music and all of a sudden want to turn that into a message and spread a positive impact through it, I'm all about supporting that. Like coming up with catchy songs, like a hook like this that you can sing along to, that you can vibe out to, that's still entertaining, that's still catchy. But at the same time, you want to leave people with something different. You want to impart a more positive impact on them and their lives, and maybe look at you a little bit differently and look at the world through your lens and how you see it and some of the shit you've been through and what you want to talk about. Man, overall, just a rock solid track. And J. Cole, we know what J. Cole does on features. Lil Durk, J. Cole, you are Noxo certified. Hope you guys like today's video. Listen, if for some reason you're here at the end, obviously enjoy the content. Do me a huge favor, support channel directly. Subscribe, notifications on. It really, really does go a long way. I love you. Stay safe, stay positive. It's one only Noxo. You know, I'll catch you again.